Episode 2941, More of We.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. I hope you're having a fabulous weekend. Can you believe it? We are 1 week away from the Super Bowl. Not that anybody's counting, but I must say, if you have someone in your family, especially your spouse, who loves the Super Bowl, yeah, start making plans now. You want to be supportive of each other. It's more of we. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, just so you know, we have partnered with pray.com. We have a live TV show there every week, Tuesday, 10:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 a.m. Pacific. I would love to see you over there and welcome you to the pray.com family. It is fun. And we've got AIM coming up. Yes, inspiring connection and community. It is going to be delightful, I pray. And it's really going to be a time for us to come together. And so be on the lookout. There's details coming. It's going to be a few weeks so before you hear them, but you'll want to stay tuned here and also get on the newsletter. Okay, enough about all of that, even though it's all important. I want to really have you focus on relationships, your marriage specifically. Life can get in the way of loving those closest to us, right? Especially our spouses. So instead of hiding in our busyness and floundering more in someone else's highlight reel, make a commitment to more of we. Now, I know it should be more of us grammatically, right? But I want you to see it as more of we. We need to do it together. We need to go to bed at the same time. We need to do the dishes. We need to hang out and watch a movie, right? It's the we, not us hang out. That sounds strange, right? So how much time do you spend with your spouse? I know you haven't thought about that question, have you? Or maybe you have. Maybe it was like 10, 12 years ago, though. And would you say that you spend less time together now than when you got married? Most of us really have to stop and think when we see our sweethearts. And as for the time, what time is it again? Isn't it time to go to bed? Isn't it time to cook dinner? Isn't it time to get the kids to their basketball game or dance practice? The number one relationship, if you're married, is your spouse. But very quickly, we find other ways to occupy our time, distract our attention, and lead us down this rabbit hole in our own homes. It just does not seem fair to anyone. Yet you live it every day. You get up and you do your thing and forget that there's someone in your life. You take care of the children because you have to, but the rest is left to fend for themselves. How can any marriage be awesome if that's a typical everyday? But what if you were to make time for each other? What if there was more of we? That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy, more of we. And my goal here is to get you thinking about how you spend time with your spouse. Are you showing up with your best self, or is your spouse getting the leftovers? Think about that for a moment. Leftovers are great for food, not so much for love. You know, you get out what you put into your marriage. So why not show up with enthusiasm? Why not give more even when you don't receive? Why not give and have compassion during challenges in life? Why not be together more than you are apart? It's hard to build a strong foundation in marriage if you're not together. Logistics do matter. You know, I go back to my dating time. My husband and I dated for 3.5 years, and during that time, we were apart. We met in college, and we attended the same college, but then my father went off to war, and so I decided to go back home to be with the family, which was the right decision. Now, my husband and I, well, then at the time, right, he was my boyfriend, we continued to date, but I was at a different university. I returned, and upon my returning, he went to a different university. Now, we were within the same town, but it wasn't as easy. And I wouldn't say the same town, in the same kind of general vicinity, right? He was more downtown, inner city, and I was more outskirts, suburban. And so we didn't get a lot of time together like we did when we first got together and we were dating at the very, very beginning, right? The first, I don't know, few months. But even then, summer came and we were separated then, and we didn't have cell phones. Do you remember 10 cents on the weekends for phone calls? Yeah, well, back then we didn't even do that. We wrote letters back and forth, long letters. And, you know, it was interesting because as I was thinking about this whole episode, I was like, you know what? When we date, we make time. But when we're married, we don't. How can a marriage stay together if you don't make time for each other? Logistics do matter. Now, when my husband and I, back to dating, when we were just dating, right, back in the earlier days, we did make time for each other, right? We made time to drive and we planned it. Do you plan your time together with your spouse now? Or do you just expect it to happen? Because I don't know about you. Let's see. Kids, kids, more kids. Community activities. You know, you got then career involved in there. And then, oh, wait. You've got responsibilities called, we got to put food on the table, so I got to go grocery shopping. Then you have other things that just happen. You got to take care of the house. Oh, and there's laundry. Right? Dinner, dishes, and dogs. What are we going to do? It gets a little bit crazy. Where does our time go? You can't build a strong foundation if you don't spend time together. So I want to encourage you to analyze your time with your spouse. And I know this sounds strange, but I really do, because I want this to spur on your next step. So number one, how much time do you spend together in bed? Now, I'm not asking what you do in bed. I'm just saying, how much time do you spend together in bed? Let me be honest. My husband gets up at crack of dawn and he goes to bed very early. What do you think happens with me? I get up not quite at the crack of dawn, but still early, but after him. And when do I go to bed? Oh, at the crack of dawn. Do you think there's much time spent together in bed? Not really. And I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but those few hours that you have together, whether you're sleeping or whether you're watching a movie or whether it's intimacy, whatever it is for you, they're important. How much time are you spending together in bed? Number two, how much time do you spend as a couple awake and interacting? Think about that one. When your hubby comes home from work, you're done with your day, dinner's finished. How much time awake are you actually then, you know, interacting with each other? Or do you just sit on your side of the living room or family room and he sits on the other side, and the next thing you know, there's three or four words and it's like, oh, it's time for bed, or mom, can you help me with this? Or, ah, you know, the puppy dog just did this, and then you have to go rescue something. We know how that goes. Oh, wait, mom, I need 2 dozen of cookies by tomorrow morning. You're like, seriously? And what time is it? 9:30. And you're thinking, oh, please let a store be open to where I can just go get cookies that are already made, right? How much time do you spend as a couple awake and interacting? And number three, how much time do you spend talking about life, not just kids and career? This is a hard one. If you go out for date night, what are the rules? Do you have rules? Do you have boundaries? We tried this. Didn't really work so well with us. Why? Well, you have 5 kids. And with 5 kids, life happens. I mean, they are so wrapped up in everything. And now we have a son-in-law and we have a grandbaby. And oh my goodness, it is awesome. But it gets even more crazy. Where is your time spent? How are you spending it with your spouse? I really want you to analyze it, because for me, this was an eye-opener and I was just taking notes. And I'm like, oh, I need to go think about this. And I have. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to make some changes. Are you? Because when you analyze this, you're going to be able to see what is happening regarding your time. You're going to see, well, do I really spend time with him? Do I really love on my spouse like I need to? Is time on your side? Now, assuming you fall into quote unquote most of us, then you can make some tweaks to how you hang out together, right? The way you spend your time matters. You get to choose. So my question for you today to ponder over this weekend, what can you do differently to add time to love? What can you do? I mentioned the Super Bowl. I know, maybe you're not a football person, and that's okay. You don't have to love football, but if your spouse does, then start planning now. Time together. More of we. Let me tell you, it's hard when all of a sudden you find yourself about ready to lose your spouse. No one wants to be in that position. My friends, you can't get time back. And this is not at all to scare you or shake you up. This is to bring a reality to the highlight reels that you're following, to the scrolls. Seriously, put it down. No more. Do something different. Shake it up a little bit. I don't know what. But get out of the same old, and get back into each other's eyes. Get back into each other's hearts. What can you do differently to add time to love? My prayer for you is that you will open up your heart to feel love, but also to share love. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.